Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about how to install Windows Package Manager. So let's get into it. All right, so today is all about Windows Package Manager, right? Let's go, right? On the desktop, I'm going to right-click on my start menu, going to pick Run. Within here, I'm going to type in WinVer, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Windows 10 version 2004. Now, on my desktop, I'm going to click on the Start menu, and I'm going to start typing Store. We're going to click on Microsoft Store to load it up, and on the upper right-hand side, we're going to click on the Search, and within Search, we are going to type in App Installer. Okay, I think one of the prerequisites is that you need to be part of the developer's preview program to use this or for this to work. Once you do that, we're going to click on it. Once you're here, we are going to click on Get. And once you get, it's going to install. And then on your lower right-hand side, on your notification section, it's going to say that App Installer was just installed, which is great. Now, to use it, it's not a program that you can actually click on Start, locate it, and load it up. You got to use a little bit of command prompt to use it. So we are going to click on Start, and within Start, we're going to go all the way to the bottom and locate Windows Terminal. I'm going to right click on it, go to More, and I'm going to run it as an administrator. I'm going to click Yes at the user account control, and it's going to load up. By default, it's going to load up the Windows PowerShell, so I'm going to click on the little arrow and load up the command prompt. Awesome. Now, to use this app manager, we're going to use the command of WinGet. When you hit enter, it gives you a nice little history of how to use it, what parameters you could use within this command. Now, the first command that I'm going to do is WinGetSearch, because if you look at it, it says it finds and shows basic info on apps, and it's going to start indexing itself and locating all the apps, and then bam, it's going to load all the apps that you're able to install. Cool, right? Now, I'm going to install WinSCP because I don't have it on my machine. If I click on my Start menu and I type in WinSCP, as you can see, I don't have it installed, right? It's trying to take me to Bing to install it or download it. So if I go inside the command prompt, I'm going to type in WinGet install and the name of the app. For us, it's going to be WinSCP. I'm going to hit Enter. It's going to start searching for it. It's going to start downloading it, installing it. And depending on what you're going to install for this particular program, it wants me to choose something. So I'm going to pick what I want. I picked install for all users, clicked on it, and then the installation was successful. Awesome. Now, if I click on the start menu and I type in WinSCP, you're going to see it's an app now. It's not going to outside to download it. And that's it, guys. That is how you install and use the app manager within Windows 10. Now, to me, I think the app manager is extremely powerful because you can actually automate this stuff to your users at your 9-to-5 jobs and just push out apps remotely. How awesome is that? Hopefully, guys, enjoy this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Do not forget about punching, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.